Ah, you lie on the beach and decide to swim before going to bed. You go into the water up to your knees and notice a bluish-green glow in the distance. It seems to you that a gem reflects the moonlight, so you go ahead. Stop and get out of there! The glow floats in your direction, and you see a small fish through the water the size of a cat. Its skin glows. It doesn't look unsafe, but in fact, it's one of the most dangerous fish on the planet. You won't confuse the cookie-cutter shark with other marine predators. It has a round mouth armed with small, sharp teeth, which can leave a mark on a wooden boat the shape of cookies. Despite its size, this fish scares great white sharks, whales, hammerhead sharks, you name it. Once, it even managed to damage the submarine with its bites. Usually, this predator lives deep in the ocean, but there are cases when it attacks people. You're diving, looking at the seafloor, and suddenly notice that it begins to move. There are several types of fish that can merge with the sea landscape, and one of them is the angel shark. It looks like a stingray and seems quite friendly. Don't swim close to it. This predator is fast and has a strong jaw filled with sharp teeth. It's aggressive and can attack. You're swimming in the water with a mask and see a shoal of small fish in the distance. Something long flies into the shoal and begins to churn the water. Fish swim away in different directions. That must be the thresher shark catching prey. This shark has a long tail, similar to a whip, and it uses it to stun little fish. Of course, if the shark sees danger, it will wave its tail for defense, and you don't want to get under this strong strike. If you see a fish with small ridges over its eyes, looking like horns, then know that it's most likely the horn shark. This predator is not aggressive. It calmly swims in seas and oceans and searches for its favorite foods – crabs, crayfish, prawns, and sea urchins. But it's still better not to approach it, as the shark has one of the strongest bites among all species. And its back and fins are covered with sharp spikes. And if you see one off the Normandy coast of France, it must be the French horn shark. Nah, I just made that up. One of the scariest sharks you can meet is the goblin shark. You can recognize it by long tail and pinkish skin tone. It lives off the Japanese coast and got its name from its unusual appearance. Imagine that you're on a boat and see this shark swimming by. You take a steak out of the container and raise it over the ocean. The shark comes out of the water and reaches for food. At this point, it opens its mouth and a jaw with sharp teeth moving out of it grabs the meat from your hand. The shark slides the jaw back and swims away. Gee! To meet this shark, you need to go down to the bottom of the ocean. There's almost no light there, but you'll see it from afar. A glowing blue head. The shark's body is black and can't be seen, so it looks like the head is swimming by itself. This small predator can fit in an adult's palm, but it's better not to try to hold it if you don't want to meet with little sharp teeth. It's called Ninja Lantern Shark. Nobody knows exactly why its head is glowing. It may be a way to lure prey, but there's also a theory that sharks communicate with each other using light. In the deep ocean waters, you can see a large snake. It seems like it's crawling on the seafloor. Its movements are fast and agile. This marine predator is also a shark. The frilled shark is similar to a snake, not only in appearance. It can also swallow prey larger than half of its 7-foot body. It has about 200 sharp teeth. You won't confuse it with a sea eel and other snake-like sea creatures. In the cold waters, where most sharks don't swim, you can meet this incredible creature. Most likely, you won't see it, because the short-finned mako shark swims too fast. It's about 35 miles per hour, which is faster than a leopard. Its prey has no chance of escape, and its enemies will never catch up with it. If you see a small glowing cave with unusual teeth looking like plates moving toward you from the depths, then you should immediately get out of the water. Although it's unlikely you can see this creature in person. The megamouth shark is one of the rarest sharks in the world. Scientists have not yet fully studied it. This fish, the size of a car, rarely closes its large mouth, which can easily fit an adult human. Fortunately, it eats plankton and won't do you harm. Yeah. You won't confuse this shark with anything else. The saw shark is a fish with a long nose similar to a saw. Those little cogs on the shark's nose are teeth that grow outwards. Each tooth is equipped with an electroreceptor that can sense the electric fields coming from other fish. In conditions of poor visibility, this shark can detect prey using its nose as a radar. The shark saw masters the saw as a professional swordsman and can hit strongly and accurately. A shark that will notice you much earlier than you do it is the hammerhead shark. Its eyes, placed on the size of the hammer, look in almost all directions at once. No fish can swim past this shark unnoticed. It uses its head not only for panoramic observation, but also for hunting. Hammerhead sharks' favorite food is stingrays. They're like blankets, invisibly floating on the seafloor. But they can't hide from the sharp eyes of this shark. It uses the hammer to pin the stingrays to the ground. Hey, how about we get the saw shark and hammerhead shark together and do a little carpentry? I could use a chair. In the waters of the Arctic, if you are lucky enough, you can meet the Greenland shark. You can rarely find this large, slow, but majestic creature on the surface, since it dwells in the ocean depths. It can live for an impressive 300 years and longer, so some of them probably witnessed the times when all ships were made of wood. White and tiger sharks are some of the main species that pose a danger to people. You can identify them by the triangular fins sticking out of the water, but it's much easier to predict their appearance if you pay attention to the external environment. You're much more likely to meet sharks early in the morning or late in the evening. At this time, it's better to relax on the beach and not get into the water. Also, you should avoid river mouths with silt and muddy water. This is where tiger sharks, some of the most bad-tempered sharks in the world, most often live. But the main sign that sharks are somewhere around is fishing boats. If you see them on the horizon, don't go into the water. People use nets to catch large numbers of fish. And where there are a lot of fish, there's a shark swimming around and trying to get food. If you're in the water and already see a shark swimming towards you, then you still have a chance to survive. The main thing is not to panic, it says here. Don't splash and don't make sudden movements not to excite the shark. Don't swim away from it because it can think you're prey. The shark will circle around you, so don't lose sight of it. You can slowly swim to the shore until you reach shallow water, then quickly escape. But be careful, the shark can even get you out of there. If the shark still attacks you, then you'll have to fight for your life. Weak points of the shark are eyes and gills. And hey, let me know how it goes.